Hello everyone, welcome back to Sun Innovative YouTube channel, and we are back with a new video on MPPT controller for the solar rooftop system. So in a last video we have published one system that which is included the solar panel and the irradiation control method, and in which we have also seen the open loop simulation for the solar panel, and we have also seen that how the irradiation is going to affected on a power generation. So for that we are coming with a new video on MPPT controller, so in which we are working on a closed loop system here, and we will also see that how to achieve the maximum power from the solar rooftop system. So first of all, I would like to explain you that why it is important for the MPPT for the solar system and the solar rooftop plant. So here it is. So first of all, we will go for the theory here. So this is the basically diagram for the MPPT controller. So this is the block diagram here, this is the PV array, and this is a DC-DC converter, and this is the load here, and this is the signals which we are taking from the boost converter for the MPPT, and this is the PWM which gives the pulses for the DC converter. So here it is a basic concept of MPPT technique here. So in which you can see that each and every graph having the maximum power point graph here at this top of the IV characteristic. So here you can see this is the X and Y axis power and voltage source here. So it is a graph of different irradiation and the maximum power we are gaining from the output. So our aim is to generate the maximum power from the solar system, at which whenever the dp by dv ratio is become zero, so it will give us the maximum power at this point. So this is our aim, to gain this power from the solar system. So here in this system we have one another circuit and the algorithm for the technique which is called the incremental technique, in which here one algorithm is developed for the MPPT technique here. So first of all, you need to measure the voltage and current values, and you need to define the difference between the voltage for the old value and the new values. So if you're getting the two values from the MPPT technique measurement VI characteristic, and that will going to satisfy this condition, like if delta V is become zero, yes or no, so this should be work in for the decreased voltage or increased voltage. So these are the two different conditions for need to develop for the MPPT technique. So I have also defined and I have also derived this technique, and we have calculated this equation, and we have developed the incremental MPPT here. So I will going to open this block and I will explain you that how is going to work here in this case. So first of all, must remember, we need to define this how the maximum power point is going to work, and because this is a very complex theory, incremental conductance, it is not a simple task to achieve the solar radiation from the solar panel and everything. So this is a difficult, so for that we need to also justify that how the simulation is going to work for this theory. So now we will start for this theory here at this point. So let me open the all block here. So if you don't know about how to generate this signal and how the irradiation is working for this simulation, so you can go to the part 1 video and you can verify the simulation and you can come back to this closed loop system. So here the signals from the IGBT is coming from this closed loop system, and these two signals which is coming from the voltage of the solar and the current of the solar, and this is the block, and it is a main block of the solar MPPT here. So this basically works on an algorithm which I have also shown you in theory portion. Sorry, let me open this subsystem. This works on this theory here. This is the one algorithm, and the equation is developed in this block based on this equation. So you can use this each and every block, and you can find out from the Simulink library browser. You can develop this block by your own. And basically I have put these values for this Fourier series to getting the error signal which is required to prevent the input voltage as a previous case, old voltage and the new voltage. So it will give the error voltage to the further system, and it will work on a algorithm which I show you here, this basically, and that is goes to the duty control here at this point. So you can also going to adjust the fixed duty for the system, and it will be going to saturation and it will be going to pulse generator for this point, and that pulse is given to this IGBT. So let me open this block also. So here switching frequency is 5000 and sample time as usual I have set for the 50 microsecond. And now moving to the other portion. So this is the irradiation. So let me again explain you this thing. So here is the starting point at which irradiation shows the 800, and simultaneously I created one fault here at this point, and at that time your irradiation is goes down, and again it will be returned back to the 1000 irradiation and continue to the for the system. And this is the temperature effect at which I have created one jump here. So at the 2 seconds it will fall down and again it will start rising at this point. So it will show the some cloud effect on atmosphere. So you can also implement this temperature falling to the system, so that you can check your system whether it is working for the temperature also or not. Point is that in any case the temperature or irradiation is changed here, so your system should not be changed the power, or your power output capacity should not be affected due to this both effect of irradiation and the temperature. That is our point here. So for that we need to see that the simulation is working perfect or not. So I am running this simulation here. So let me run this simulation, and here you go, you can see this is the solar output and this is the boost output voltage according to the irradiation values which we have given to the solar panels. And this is, you can see this is the output boost voltage, and this blue line it is a solar output voltage. So it is, you see this portion is due to the irradiation is get down at this point which we have created for the signals which is here. And if you look at the power, so you can find out here. So you see this red line is shows the irradiation capacity which we have developed from the solar system, and this is the maximum power which we are going to gaining from the system. And you can just compare these two values here. So you see here, this is the approximately desired desired power capacity, and we are getting the maximum power at this solar system. It is a very huge difference between this. So you can see this is the graph of the power, so that you can achieve the maximum power at this point. So this way it is going to work at this different condition. But now how we can justify that it is working perfectly, or our result is working good or not. So you can refer the many research paper and the base paper. So you will be find that every theory is having this type of graph that will going to show you that this is the maximum power tracking system. So likewise we need to also develop this maximum power tracking system for the graph of our simulation, so that we can verify that our simulation is working perfectly or not. So I will take the XY graph from the Simulink library browser from here, and I will going to connect this graph for the X, that is a 1 voltage, and second that is for the power, so that I can generate this type of graph which I have shown earlier just now, so that our maximum power we can track from the system. So here it is. So this is 0, and let me take this is one around 3000 because of the power is very high, and let me take this 100 only. So if you are going to run this simulation, so you will be find the XY graph on the system. Sorry, I just did mistakes. I need to make it 300 to 100, and this must be 3000 because on a Y axis I have taken the power. So you see here, this is the XY graph of the system, in which you can see that this is the maximum power. So let me open this theory so you can understand these things. So you see, and you just compare this point, our MPPT is working on a maximum power which I have mentioned in every graph of here. In a theory, you can see this is running almost on the top of the system, and once your irradiation is coming down or it is slow, so it will be coming to the below point. So you can see, and you can refer this graph for this one, the different irradiation having the different maximum power tracking point. And it also shows the different values for the irradiation, and it also working on a maximum point like this way. And you can refer this graph for the maximum point, and it goes very high, you can see here. Let me pick this one, and it will going upward direction. So this is shows the it is working on a maximum power tracking system at this point. So this way it is important that how you design your MPPT called closed loop system for the generation of the maximum power which is coming from the system. So basically you start with this algorithm to understand this how it's going to work and what are the advantages having this one, and you can develop this graph or you can verify your system whether it is working properly or not by this way. So this is the MPPT technique you can develop, and you can understand your system by using this MPPT incremental system. So in the next video we are going to develop the P&O, Perturb and Observe method for the MPPT controller, and at that part 3 we will going to conclude that which is more better, but which is more better than incremental or the P&O method, so that we can understand that our user has to develop the technique which is more preferable, more suitable for the your research purpose. So this is the point of our simulation of MPPT controller, that you are gaining to maximum power from the system. So again, let me show you this graph and the XY graph here. So when you run this simulation, so that graph will show you like this way. So you can understand this is how the maximum technique is going to work at this point. So this is the data when we change the irradiation from the input of solar. So it will check the again and again voltage values, and it will take the maximum power as much as possible from the system. You can see here, and the simulation is running, so it is taking the maximum power from the system by this way, like this way. And this is when we change the irradiation values from the input, and it is taking every point of maximum theory and maximum power from the system. So this is where you can also develop your system for the MPPT technique. So thank you guys, thank you very much for watching this video, and please wait for the next video of the P&O method of the solar MPPT. Thank you.